ఆదిభ్యో బ్రహ్మ విద్యా సంప్రదాయ కర్తృభ్యో వంశ ఋషుభ్యో మహద్భ్యో నమో గురుభ్యః సర్వోప్లవరహిత ప్రజ్ఞాన గణ ప్రత్యగర్థో బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి సోహమస్మి బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి ఓం పార్థాయ ప్రతిబోధితాం భగవతా నారాయణేన స్వయం వ్యాసేన గ్రథితాం పురాణమునినా మధ్యే మహాభారతం అద్వైతామృతవర్షిణీం భగవతీం అష్టాదశాధ్యాయినీం అంబ త్వామనుసందధామి భగవద్గీతే భవద్వేషిణీం నమోస్తు తే వ్యాస విశాలబుద్ధే ఫుల్లారవిందాయతపత్రనేత్ర ఏన త్వయా భారత తైలపూర్ణః ప్రజ్వాలితో జ్ఞానమయః ప్రదీపః ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైకపాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుహే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. May Venkateswara bring all kinds of auspices to all of us. Srimad Bhagavad Gita, verse number 41 of second chapter. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Vyavasayatmika Buddhihi Yekeha Kurunandana Bahusakhahyanantascha Buddhayo Vyavasayinam. Lord Krishna began the secret of karma from last two verses. And we were discussing about what bhavana is. Some people may got a little bit confused what exactly the bhavana is. We learn a little bit more about bhavana with one more example. There was a tycoon, name was Sundaramurti. He loved his father well. After his father's death, he used to miss him a lot. Then in those days, there was no color cameras, only black and white cameras. He had his father's black and white photos. Then he wanted to get a painting, you know, with all the colors. He said his manager to get a great artist. Then a great artist was brought in front of him and he gave the photo and said, you know, this is my father. Okay, so you have to draw thoroughly, completely, exactly like him, but with the color. I will mention you what kind of color the dress he used and what kind of brand watch and shoes and cap he used and what kind of thick it was he used. Then he made a complete list and handed it over to that artist. Then artist also said that, okay, done sir, we will be ready, it will be ready in 1 week. After a week, when he was invited to see the paint, he went and the paint was very beautifully done. But instead of getting happiness, he started shouting like anything. How can you do this? How dare you are? How could you change the color which I gave to the coat? And you changed this cap color also, and eyebrows also, it has to be a little bit lengthened. You made it very shorter, and beard, it has to be a little bit longer. This artist was stunned because he had never ever had this kind of experience from the customer. Then he said, sir, whatever the changes you need, let me know immediately, I will draw again. No, 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 I need completely fresh one. Then it was made. After a week he came again and he saw everything was done. And he was so happy and it was placed at his home in a front yard. And everybody who comes inside, they have to respect him. Then they used to come. One day in the morning, his maid was cleaning that dust around the photo with the broomstick. That's all. He throws something which he had in his hand, then maid was injured. There is an incident. Now, when he gave the picture, he said, "This is my father." Was it his father? No. It was a paper. It was a photo. It was a snap. But he said, "This is my father." And when he looked the photo, he used to see, "My father's eyebrows were lengthened, you made it short." He could see his father in the eyebrows, in the brand, in the color, and in the shoes, in the stick. He could see the father. When somebody was doing a cleaning job with a broomstick, immediately he throws something. It's because of what? For him, he doesn't believe that photo or painting is the father. He could see, he could give the existence of his father. That is known as bhavana. You have to see it. See it means when you look at a statue, a panchaloka vigraha, when it is brought and done prana pratishtha, you have to see the deity. When you see the deity, exactly the deity becomes alive. That is the secret behind the puja. That is the secret behind the karma. When you see, your perception makes wonder. Your perception is because of what? Your understanding. That is what called bhavana. What kind of bhavana? That I can fix with karma. See, a person was going Tirumala. I used to go every year to Tirumala through staircase, through steps. We were climbing on the steps. There was one more theme had come, but one aged person, he was, you know, traveling with us, climbing the steps. I asked him, "So, what is the purpose? You know, you have become old enough. You need now to climb on. Balaji is not a sadist. He is a Karuna Murthy. You can go through bus." Then he said, "Swamiji, it is not like that. You know, my wife, she was supposed to die last year. I had, you know, prayer. If my wife is got cured, I will come through the steps. She was perfectly all right. Therefore, I have to. I climbed at that time also, and I climb now also." So, the happiness which he had, I could see Balaji in him. That's the bhavana. See, when he went first time with the prayer, that time there was a longing and completely connected with Balaji through every steps. Okay, that was the karma. That was not the karma. The steps, if you go to Ooty or Kodaikanal or somewhere in the 10th floor building, you also climb the steps. That the same job, but here it is done with a different bhavana. It gives different fruit. That is the magic of karma yoga. That is the magic of the universal function. We have to understand it. And why should we understand it? Because when Arjuna was in the trouble, Krishna gave the supreme knowledge. That supreme knowledge is, you are nothing but Brahman alone. You are not born, you are not going to die. You are vikara rahitaha, means you don't have any modifications. But Arjuna was not able to understand it. He was not able to accept it. Because when you believe you have the body, you are born. When you believe there is a world, then what? Upanishad means our Vedas, they do magic. They take a travel like a drunken person who was blabbering like anything, being in front of his home, he used to shout, "Please, can you, anybody help me to get my home? My mother is waiting for me." Being in front of his home alone. And people used to say, "No, you are in front of your house alone, man." But he was not able to, means he was drunken, therefore what, he was not ready to listen it. Can you help me? Can somebody help me? He was shouting. One person did a magic. He brought a two-wheeler and he said, sit, I will take you and I will make you to reach your home. Then he made a round and he dropped. He said, thank you, sir, thank you. I got my home. I want to see my mother. In the same way, when you believe there is the world other than me, it means no medicine is available in this world. Because you have the bhavana, you have the belief, you don't believe, you see the world. Like that business tycoon, he saw his father in his snap. You see the world. Your perception does the job and you see so many things. You see the world and you see also the difference between the world. You make chaos your life itself. You see that you were born though you were not understood when you were coming out of your home, your mother's womb. But when you are going to die, that time also you are not going to see your death because you will just undergo one more modifications. But you believe that I am going to die, I was born, I am suffering like anything, and also you be that I am this body. You see everything you see. Therefore Shastra says that is called bhavana. You have to be careful with your bhavana when you perform this dharma karma. Therefore Arjuna, Krishna says, Arjuna, you are going to fight again, but not like before. Because now you know who you are. Whether you are not able to understand, that doesn't matter, but you have to keep yourself fit to karma. Because karma is a weapon, it is an inert object. This inert object means what? It has got its own pre-programmed nature to produce karma phala. Whoever does the job, it will produce the karma phala. But that karma, a single karma will provide different fruits, means different phala according to the person's bhavana, means perception. Therefore, when he talks about karma, means bhavana, your buddhi has to be focused. That's what in the 41 shloka he emphasizes. Vyavasayatinka buddhihi. You should have a focused mind. What is that focused mind means? So every religion has got its own concept of defining creation, defining moksha, and defining what exactly the bondage is. Now you have to be endowed completely to what I am going to teach. You erase everything from your buddhi. You have to be fresh enough and you have to be open-minded. Vyavasayatmika buddhi means it is completely focused with a proper bhavana. That bhavana, what kind of bhavana means? Middle. I have to be in the middle. He himself will explain it. Therefore he said karma is not outside. That is one information we got it. We should know that. The first understanding is I am nothing but Brahman. But the second understanding is karma is not outside, karma is inside. So Brahman cannot penetrate into the karma. Brahman remains as the Brahman. He himself will explain. We need not to get confused. Okay. Therefore he says, Bahushaka hi anantaha. So many ideologies are available in this world about karma, about life, about you, about death, about dreams. So many ideologies, so many thoughts, schools of thoughts are available. Don't get scattered by all of them. Just be focused with this buddhi yoga. Then he continues, Buddhi Yoga means what in further shloka but in different way.
Yami mam pushpitam vacham pravadantya vipaschitah vedavadarata partha nanyadastiti vadinah.
River flows towards what? Towards pit. Because river's nature is to go down. In the same way, mind has got its own nature. It always runs behind the result. Without thinking result, you cannot be endowed with any karma. When you brush your mouth, you have the expectation of the teeth, white, crystal clear teeth. When you take a bath, you expect you should be a very fresh, full person. When we select a dress, we always think that it should be a part of personality. It should expose my gigantic personality. In good sense, what I say is in good sense, I should appear, look good. This expectation, without expectation, we take breakfast with the expectation that I should get energy. Without expectations, no karma can be done. The mind is slave to expect karma phala. And even this all outside world is nowadays advertisement world. You see the advertisement in the TVs, there are beautiful advertisements. So within a 40 seconds, they cover the whole life and the emotions. These all emotions are very nicely shown in those advertisement. I sometimes become amazed by the way they present the emotions, and finally they project the brand, the material, what they manufacture. Like this benefit is shown. Because that's their job, you know. When you use their brand, as though you become pure, white and fresh enough, phala-oriented mind. Mind always thinks about phala. Immediately you go to shop. When they ask soap, your advertisement will work from your mind. Whatever that you see with the expectations of the fruit. That's what mind is. Therefore, don't get cheated by this outside world. Even you need not to be cheated by the first portion of Vedas. Because Vedas means karma kanda here. If you get it done, this havan, yaga, yajna, homa, you will get this power, money, luxurious life, and you may become Indra. You become a big, a powerful man in the universe. Don't get scattered away. Therefore, he says, Yam imam pushpitam vacham vipaschitaha prabadanti vedavadarataha partha na anyat asti iti vadinaha. These certain type of people will say, this world is karma mayam. This world is only karma phala. Okay? Therefore what? You have to be always endowed with karma. If you want to get a successful life, you have to work, 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 work. You have to give your complete 100% head into that. Then you can achieve something. You have to depend on the karma which is not needed. He says, the first we think that if I do something, I will gain something. That's true. But you need not to do something to gain something. Always our problem, what you know? We want to become somebody. When you want to become somebody like, you lose yourself. No flowers in the forest compares with other people. No animal it compares with other people. Other people means other, that species, other creature. The human being alone, we compare, we expect, and we want to make effort to get that. He says, even you should not be scattered away by the words of Vedas when they say it's a flourishing words. That don't get scattered away.
Kamatmana swarga paraha janma karma phala pradam kriya vishesha bahulam bhogaishwarya gatim prati.
Now Krishna is working with our perception. When you have a proper bhavana, or you have the clarity of bhavana, you can understand this. These all Vedas means karma kantas, kamatmanaha, swarga paraha, janma karma phala pradam, kriya vishesham, kriya vishesha bahulam, bhogaishvarya gatim prati. They lead you towards enjoyment to be enjoyed in this life. They are kamatmanaha. They talk about so many desires and so many enjoyments. And swarga paraha, they also talk about not in the earth, it also talks about hereafter in swarga, whatever the enjoyments are there. You can also make effort, you can also work for that to achieve. And janma karma phala pradam, it makes you to believe that you have been born and you are going to die. After death you are going to travel to swarga or naraka. Everything is done by Vedas. And Shesha Bhagulan, it asks you to be endowed with good dharma karyas. It talks about only enjoyments, enjoyments, enjoyments. And wealth and health and everything. We need them. But here the teaching is far beyond a normal people. You have to realize when you want to experience completely spiritual, that supreme conscious one, you have to be ready to understand 100% the fact what it is. We need money, we need health, we need happiness, we also need the family around us. We need not to give up anything, but we should have the clarity. When Shastra says you are unborn, you are not able to understand, then you have to analyze what the karma is. Now the karma theory, he says, yes, when you look at the world which is created, everything is karma phala, but don't get scattered. Krishna continues, bhogaishvarya prasaktanam tayapakrta chetasam vyavasayatmika buddhihi samadhau na vidhiyate. These words of Vedas, which are in the form of flourishing and endowed with so many attractive fruits, will disturb you. Be careful. This disturbance won't allow you to settle with vyavasayatmika buddhihi. When you want to analyze about karma, you have to be completely detached. Detached means what? You have to be completely aware about yourself. Because the all words, including Vedas, including so many structures of the philosophies, they are just only about trigunas. Traigunya vishaya vedaha nistraigunyo bhavarjuna nirdvandvo nitya sattvasthaha niryoga kshema atmavana. He says, this world is nothing but triguna. They talk about the world and fruits, all of them only the modification of trigunas. What are those trigunas? We will continue from tomorrow. the next episode. My blessings to all of you. May the Lord Venkateswara provide to consume, to assimilate the knowledge given by our forefathers. We will study again and again. We will dig again and again to assimilate it. Definitely, Lord will help us to assimilate. See you in the next class. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.